Now let us see question number 4. Should the function defined from real numbers to the range is given, minus 1 is lesser than x lesser than 1. That means range is between minus 1 and 1. So it is from real numbers to minus 1 to 1. It is defined by fx is equal to x upon 1 plus mod x. So we have to show that it is one minute onto function. So first of all, let me write the function over here. The function is fx is equal to x upon 1 plus mod x. Correct? Now, well, how do mod x works? So we'll see the definition of mod x. Mod x works, mod x is equal to x. I can write the definition over here. Fx is equal to fx is equal to x upon 1 minus x if x is lesser than 0, and it is equal to x upon 1 plus x if x is greater than 0. Right? So we'll take different cases over here for proving 1-1. So it is case 1 when we can say that the both values are greater than 1-1. That means both the values are positive. X is positive. That means now I'm considering the case when x1 and x2 both are positive values greater than 0. Right? So let fx1 is equal to fx2. It implies x1 upon 1 plus x1 is equal to x2 upon 1 plus x2. So which implies x1 plus x1 x2 is equal to x2 plus x1 x2. We can cancel, so that means x1 is equal to x2, so it is definitely 1-1. We'll take another case, case 2, when x1 x2 are less than 0. So function will take the, again we will write let fx1 is equal to fx2. This we have to write every time. Right? So x1 upon 1 minus x1 is equal to x2 upon 1 minus x2. It will lead to x1 minus x1 x2 is equal to x2 minus x1 x2. It will get cancelled. So x1 is equal to x2. So again it is a 1-1 mapping. Again it is 1-1 over here. Now let us see, there are two cases. Now let us take third case also, when one value is even and another value is odd. Okay. So let us say x1 is odd and x2 is even. So the definition changes. Now again we'll be taking let fx1 is equal to fx2. It implies when x1 is odd, so it will be x1 upon 1 minus x1 is equal to, it is not even or odd, sorry, when x1 is less than 0, when x1 is less than 0 and x2 is greater than 0. These are the values we are taking. Okay, so x1 upon 1 minus x1 is equal to x2 upon 1 plus x2. This we need to do. So let me make the space. Okay. Right. So it is x2. So x1 plus x1 x2 is equal to x2 minus x1 x2. So it means x1 minus x2 is equal to minus 2x1 x2, or I can say x2 minus x1 is equal to 2x1 x2. Fine. X2 minus x1. So x2, what is x2? X2 is greater than 0. What is x1? Less than 0. So definitely this value is greater than 0. This value is greater than 0. But on the right hand side, what we can see, x1 is negative and x2 positive. So the result will be less than 0. So this condition is not true. Therefore, this condition can be discarded. Similarly, if we can consider another case, x1 greater than 0, x2 less than 0, again the condition will be there when it has to be discarded. So we are having two cases, either both are greater than 0 or both are lesser than 0. So the function is 1, 1. Now we'll check for the function whether it is onto. Okay, we'll check for the function whether it is onto. So again, we'll take the case when x is lesser than 0. First case. So for onto, what do we do? We write the function, we write x in terms of y. So we are given y is equal to x upon 1 plus mod x. So we'll write it when x is lesser than 0. So it will take the form y is equal to x upon 1 minus x. So y minus yx is equal to x. It implies x into 1 plus y is equal to y. It implies x is equal to y upon 1 plus y. Correct? So when x is less than 0, we have got x is equal to y upon 1 plus y. So it implies y should not be equal to minus 1. What is y? Y is the range. So y is not equal to minus 7, it is also given over here. I can write this is a range that is equal to minus 1 and 1 that we have already written. So y is not equal to minus 1. Now, what is the value of y now? When x is less than 0, so that means y plus y upon 1 plus y is lesser than 0. I should find out the value of y. Okay. So how can I find it? I can draw these on a number line. It is 0, it is equal to negative, it is positive 1. So y upon 1 plus y, which values of y will satisfy this condition? So let me take y as a positive value first. So y, let us say some y is over here. It is 0.5. So 0.5 upon 1 plus 0.5. That will give me a positive value. That means this value is discarded. It is not the part of my answer. Now let me take the value that is of y that is between 0 and minus 1. Let us say minus 0.5. So minus 0.5 upon 1 plus 0.5. Definitely it is less than 0. So I'll be having this as the result. That is y. So y over here is, y lies between minus 1 and 0. Okay. First part. Now we'll take another case when x is greater than 0. So that means y is equal to x upon 1 plus x. Now I'll be writing x in terms of y. So it will give me x is equal to y upon 1 minus y. So y upon 1 minus y is greater than 0, it is given to me. And over here I can see 1 minus y should not be equal to 1. And that is already given to me that it is not equal to 1. 1 minus y should not be equal to 0. It implies y should not be equal to 1. Correct? So x is greater than 0. So y upon 1 minus y is greater than 0. So again I have to see it on the number line. I am having 0 over here. I am having codomain limiting values minus 1 and 1. So let me take y as positive. So let us say y is equal to 0.5 again. So 0.5 upon 1 minus 0.5. So that is a value greater than 0. So it is permissible. Okay. Let me take another value, negative, minus 0.5. So y is equal to minus 0.5. So 0.5 upon 1 minus 0.5 upon 1 minus 0.5. So it will give me negative value. But I need greater than 0. So that means this range is discarded. Okay. So what is my resulting solution? I am having this as a part of my answer and this as a part of my answer. So that means my range y, because I'll be taking union of both these cases. So that means my range lies between minus 1 and 1. And what is the codomain? Codomain is also same. So it means it is on 2. So the function is 1, 1 and the function is on 2 that we have seen. Correct? Now coming to question number 5. So what is question number 5? Show that the function defined from R to R gives the fx, given by fx is equal to x cube with injective. What is injective? What is injective? It is 1, 1, we have to see, right? So again, let, what we have to let, fx1 is equal to fx2. It implies x1 cube is equal to x2 cube. It implies, sorry, it fx, okay, it is correct. So that means x1 cube minus x2 cube is equal to 0. It implies a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square is equal to 0. It implies either x1 minus x2 is equal to 0. So it gives us x1 is equal to x2. Now considering second case. So I have told you in the beginning also, for this case what we will do, we will divide this value, let us say it is capital X. We will divide capital X by x2 square. So it will give me the result as x1 upon x2 whole square, x1 upon x2 whole square, right? Let me rub it. Correct. Plus x1 upon x2 plus 1 is equal to 0. So it is a quadratic. If x1 upon x2 is equal to t, so t square plus t plus 1 is equal to 0, its roots cannot be real. Roots are not real. Roots are not real. Why? As a discriminant, that is b square minus 4ac is less than 0. Okay. So we'll discard this value. Fine. So now the result is x1 is equal to x2. So that means definitely it is injective. It is 1, 1. Fine. Let us see another question. Question number 6.